Hi, my name is Emma. Welcome to the Hive. Come on in.
Hey y'all, I'm Miley Jane.
Hey guys, I'm Tristan.
Hey guys, it's Trin.
Hey, I'm Ezra.
Hey guys, I'm Isaiah.
Hi, I'm Alexis.
I'm Xander, and you can catch us at WSMH, your station for the Jacket Nation.
Hey y'all, welcome back to WSMH,
your station for the Jacket Nation.
We are here with all the highlights for the month of September.
I am so glad to be in anchor with you this episode.
Me too. We're going to be great together, I can already tell.
With how busy this month has been, we have a lot to talk about, so I suggest we get this show on a road, sister.
You're right. With all of the homecoming events and dress-up days, we had something happen almost every day this month.
It all started with our announcements of our HOCO Corps at our first unforgettable pep rally.
You're right. What's our homecoming without our HOCO Corps?
I am so proud of the way all of our homecoming maids represented their classes. It is such an honor to be nominated.
I agree. They all looked absolutely gorgeous.
Congratulations to all of them.
Let's take a look at your 2024 homecoming maids.
Being on court.
That's so exciting. I really hope she and all the other maids enjoyed representing their classes. I think they definitely did. Dressing up and doing your makeup and feeling pretty is so much fun.
You know what else was so much fun?
What, Trin? You are new at this, so I'm not sure what you're gonna say.
Dressing up for Spirit Week!
Oh yeah! You're so right.
And honestly, I think I'm the only one who made the most out of it.
Definitely not. I saw so many creative outfits every day.
See? Everyone loves Spirit Week.
I know I do. Let's check out some of my favorite outfits.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship.
I wish every day could be a dress-up day.
I wish we had pep rallies every day.
Pep rallies?
Yes! I think you and I can both agree, St. Martin High School has, without a doubt, the best pep rallies.
I'll give you that, but I think I'd lose my voice after just a week.
Okay, you're right. So we should probably stick to the ones we already have during the school year and not anymore.
Now, if it was like our HOCO pep rally we just had, we could see about doing it every day.
Right! I had so much fun! It was amazing.
I agree. You know, we really do see eye to eye on a lot of things.
Then let's both take a look at the pep rally.
Seems to me everyone was wearing the perfect amount of blue and gold to celebrate our homecoming game.
I think us having our HOCO parade really brought out everyone's true school spirit.
I agree. Celebrating this week with my friends and catching so much candy was definitely the highlight of my week.
The floats all looked great and it was exciting to see so many. The parade gets bigger each and every year.
Congratulations to our junior for bringing the home win for the best float. It was super cute.
Yeah, most definitely. But the freshmen really gave us a run for our money.
They're going to be amazing when they're upperclassmen. I'm going to need sophomores to step up their game.
They did a good job too. Just take a look.
That everyone did endure our annual HOCO parade.
It was one of my favorite parts of the week.
Mine too. Next to dancing, you were dancing hard Saturday night.
You're supposed to dance at a dance, so I hope you were.
Most definitely, I was getting down.
We really are alike, Trinity.
We are. I had the best time getting ready to dance the night away.
Me too.
Everyone looked so good.
What can I say? Our yellow jackets not only look good on the dance floor, they look good all night long.
Well then, let's see how sharp they really are.
Time to give everyone an update on our Spirit Olympic points.
I am not sure that I want to know. Miss Parkman just said the word juniors a lot during all the announcements.
True, but it's only the end of the first 9 weeks, so anyone still has a chance.
Good. I don't want the class of 2025 to win 2 years in a row.
Then we've got our work cut out for us.
Let's find out who is taking the lead. Competition.
I think we should be more worried about the freshmen than the seniors.
Don't count the seniors out. They always try to make a comeback at the last minute.
I don't want to worry about them right now. I'm ready to start thinking about our upcoming fall break.
I can't wait. It's time to move on and focus on all of the events we can do outside of school.
It's almost spooky season, so I bet there are and still are lots of fall and Halloween events coming up.
I can't wait to go on haunted houses and scary trails this season.
Me too. You could totally do that, but I bet there's more events than haunted houses and scary trails.
Let's head over to our community news so we can get a full fall update.
Hey y'all!
Welcome to this month's community. We're gonna be talking about a lot of different things that are happening along the coast.
And this time of year is when so many of our annual events happen.
So without a further ado,
let's get started.
Terra on the Coast kicked off earlier this month.
And they're open from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. only on Fridays and Saturdays.
And it goes through November 2nd, so get your scare on.
If you're not ready for that and you don't plan on traveling to East Central for tonight's game, there are still things that you can do.
September 27th at Fort Maurepas Park is Friday at the Fort,
with live music, food trucks, and crab vendors from 6 to 9 p.m.
On October 5th, you can head over to MGM Park for the Biloxi Grand Slam. It's from 12 to 10 p.m.
Also in Biloxi, at the Biloxi Visitor Center, they will be hosting a fall fest from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., and it's free.
Now, let's talk about why we're here at downtown Ocean Springs.
Starting on October 6th, you can experience one of the biggest events of all year, all along the coast.
Cruising the coast!
There will be events every day, but Ocean Springs Big Day will start on October 10th at 10 a.m.
Check out their website or Facebook page for more information.
It will be happening all over the coast, so make sure to watch out.
After all the car watching and driving, you can head to our Outlet Mall Golf Port on October 17th for the Mama 8 Cookin' Food Truck Days.
There will be lots of food trucks there, so you don't want to miss out.
On October 18th in Goshen in the Sportsplex, there will be a movie night at 6:30.
The movie shown will be Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Mutant Mayhem, and it's free!
Also, the 18th through 20th in Diva at Sacred Heart Catholic Church, the 98th Annual Bazaar.
It's free entry, and Fridays it's 6 p.m. until, and on Saturdays and Sundays it's 11 a.m. until.
On October 26th, our Mississippi Sea Wolves will be back in season.
And if you can catch their first game at the Coliseum against the Baton Rouge Zydegos,
you can explore the historic and haunted Mary C. O'Keefe Cultural Arts Center on October 25th or 26th for Spooky Springs and enjoy their haunted house for only $5.
Finally, on October 27th, there's a fall film fest on the Biloxi Town Green.
It's from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. and there will be tons of things to do there.
And it is totally worth $5.
And believe it or not, these are just a few of the things going on until we'll be back with our next episode.
So for now, happy fall, y'all!
Seems like we have lots of events quickly coming up.
I can't wait to go to Terra on the Coast. I look forward to going every year.
Me too, but aside from the spooky attractions, I'm excited for Cruising the Coast. It's a classic. Do you get it?
Yes, Miley. Do you want to know what makes me think of that?
What, Trin? These cars are classic?
Nope, that these cars are about as antiques as our seniors.
That's a good one, Trin.
Yeah, it might have been a mistake putting us two together.
Who else would have laughed at our corny jokes? But maybe we do need to focus.
We need to lock in. The seniors need all of their info. They really will be antiques at this rate.
Yeah, but I still have lots of jokes up my sleeve.
Okay, Miley. We need to hit up our favorite senior citizen for more senior updates.
Hey guys, you already know who it is, and I'm here to tell y'all all about the senior thanks. Starting off, homecoming week was so much fun because of all the activities that were happening. Congratulations to our maids, but especially the queen. Even with all of the homecoming fun, seniors still had to take care of things. Hopefully you verified your senior portrait with Ms. Kewen. If not, see her immediately. Today and next Monday are exam days, so make sure you study. After exams, we will have our fall break from October 4th to October 13th. That's 10 whole days. After you return, we will receive report cards on the 17th, so make sure you are keeping up with your grades. Then on October 22nd is our annual Fall Fest. Now, you know us seniors love to stand out, so we won't have a regular game of candy. Seniors will be sponsoring Trunk or Treat. A sign-up sheet will be posted outside of Miss Bennett or Miss Jackson's door after the break. That's pretty much it for now, seniors, but make sure you are checking in with Miss Teeth about scholarships and priority deadlines that will be happening this semester. And like I said last time, if you can't remember everything I say because I do talk a lot, then you can go ahead and go downstairs to get a senior calendar from behind Miss Hebert's desk. I'll see you guys next month. Bye, seniors.
Hopefully the seniors got all the information they need.
I hope so too. Hopefully it didn't go through one ear and out the other.
You know how those seniors get, forgetful in their old age.
Okay, that's enough jokes about our seniors. We love you guys.
Not as much as we love our sports, especially Friday night football.
I might have to agree.
I think everyone has a blast watching all of our sports.
It seems like the fall sports season has flown by.
Especially volleyball. It seems like just yesterday we had our first volleyball game.
I bet you have lots of updates for all our fall sports.
I think it's time you come join me for our sports update.
Hey guys.
Guess what? Your girl Trent is back with someone new.
I'm Isaiah and we'll be updating you on this fall sports.
All of our sports are looking great. Football broke their 17 game losing streak against the Van Cleve Bulldogs with a score of 24-14.
And on Friday the 13th, we had a tough game against Hancock, but we brought home a dub in overtime.
I'm very proud of our football team. I see a great season ahead.
Even though we didn't win our homecoming game, we fought really hard and ended with a score of 28-15.
Tonight, we will be taking on the East Central Hornets in Hurley.
After football's bye week, we have 5 more games left. We have to make them count.
Same for volleyball. Our season is almost to an end with our last game just around the corner on October 3rd at Van Cleve.
I know it's been a tough season, but you fought hard. You have a pretty young team, so I know it'll be better next year.
True. We only have one senior. She got a whole night to herself.
Thinking of it makes me smile, but I hate to see any seniors leaving.
Me too, but we have more sports to talk about, which means more senior nights.
Definitely. It might get a bit emotional, but let's continue.
Our swim team had a meet on the 24th at the Biloxi Auditorium and looked amazing.
Good job to all of our swimmers. Let's keep it up.
I don't know if y'all noticed, but it's fall, y'all.
It's getting a bit cold for swimming, don't you think?
Yeah, but I think it'll feel great for cross country, all that running with the good old breeze.
And golf. I know they're hot being out there with all the winning they do at their matches.
On August 29th at the Preserves, Lily Radich had an opportunity to play in a 5-boy, 1-girl tournament.
Lily did great, shooting a 95 on a challenging course, and our boys had a match on the 26th at Diamond Head Cardinal Golf Course. They finished 2nd out of 20 teams.
Our boys JV Yellow Jackets won their tournament on the September 20th, led by some impressive 9-hole scores.
There are still a few matches left before their season ends, and they're hoping to make it to state at the end of October. Keep up the great work.
As we are wrapping up our fall sports, our winter sports will begin. Our first wrestling match will be Halloween Havoc here at St. Martin on October 29th.
And basketball will be starting the beginning of November.
For now, we will see you at the football game.
Go Jackets!
I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say our football team is looking amazing, defense and offense.
They should definitely be proud of themselves, but we can't forget all of our other fall sports.
We could never.
Keep an eye out for more events going on for all of our fall sports before their seasons come to an end.
I just hope the weather holds us out so that we can make our way to take on the Hornets tonight.
We really never know what to expect, or at least I don't. Aren't you going to fill us in on weather for next week?
Nope, not this time.
What? I look forward to your weather report.
Aw, that's nice, but I don't think you will be disappointed with the replacement this month. Take it away, Xander.
Hey guys, I'm Xander, your meteorologist for this episode. As we move into October, we hope the fall season finally brings us some cooler weather. After last month's episode, we had a storm come in. Thankfully, we were left mostly unharmed, with Louisiana taking the majority of the impact, but we're not in the clear yet. We're still in just the beginning of hurricane season, and hopefully all of you stay safe. There's also a hurricane hitting Florida at the moment. We send our well wishes to the safety of all residents there. It just goes to show that you can never know when a hurricane will spring up, and that you need to be prepared in case of an emergency during hurricane season. We've been having mainly sunny skies, and temperatures have stayed in the mid-80s to low 90s range, thanks to the humidity. Now, let's look at this week's forecast. This week's forecast promises temperatures in the mid-60s and mid-80s range with a week full of sunny days. There is still the chance of some pop-up showers throughout the week, so be prepared for that. Enjoy the sun while you can, and be sure to have fun. This is Xander signing off. And remember, no matter what the weather is, it's always a great day to be a Yellow Jacket.
See, Xander did a great job of filling my shoes with the weather report.
You're right. Just like you have been about so many things this episode.
I must say, you've done a great job this episode too.
Thank you. I have to say that I couldn't have asked for a better person to anchor with.
But sadly, our time has come to an end.
I knew you and I would have a ball together.
I without a doubt loved doing this HOCO episode with you, Trin.
I can't wait to do it again. Hopefully, we'll be back together next episodes with more events and maybe a few corny jokes.
Now, I don't know about the corny jokes, but definitely more events.
We will see you next time with highlights from all of our great things happening at St. Martin.
That's all for WSMH,
your station for the Jacket Nation. Bye, Jackets!
Excuse me.
Okay, y'all ready?
Unforgettable pep rally.
You're right. With homecoming, with our... What?
I have to do that to, like, because my cheekbones hurt from smiling and laughing. So...
What the freak?
6, 5.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back. Ooh, why did I say...
Okay, why is...
Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa. The second one.
Turns up with my little yeah.
My little yeah, yeah. I think I... Wait.
School.
It's almost spooky season, so I bet there still are lots of fall Halloween... Okay.
Whoa. My breast stings now from that burger. That's good to know. Cracks with Miley and Trey.
Cracks with Katie.